गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. आर सेकेंड टॉपिक, दिस इज लैंग्वेज टॉपिक एज सच. दिस इज द सेंटेंस. लेटर्स, वॉवल्स एंड कॉन्सोनेंट्स एंड वर्ड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, वॉवल्स आर फाइव, ए ई आई ओ यू. कॉन्सोनेंट्स आर, वेन वी टेक आउट फाइव वॉवल्स आउट ऑफ द अल्फाबेट्स, वी आर लेफ्ट विद 21 कॉन्सोनेंट्स. एंड with the help of these alphabets and I mean to say with the help of these vowels, consonant all together, we write words. Now after word we are coming to the next stage, that is sentence. So starting with the sentence, let me again tell you how we are doing these alphabets. Alphabets are 26 in numbers, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y and Z. Then vowels are 5, that is A, E, I, O, U. These are 5. And then consonants are, when we take out 5 from 26, we are left with 21. So consonants are 21 and words are so many, they are infinite. Just because we are making out of these 26, or whether it is vowels or consonants, words are made out of these 26 alphabets. Like for example, a small example, that is pin. So here it is vowel also and these are consonant also. So word can be made out of vowels also, out of consonants also. So we use altogether 26 alphabets to make a word. And then later on, when we come to the sentence, so words are infinite, that means they are many in numbers. Words can be thousand and thousands in number. And like I have given you example of pin, or I can write bin. So words can be made with vowels also and consonant also. So words are many. Now talking about sentences are also many. They are infinite, they are many in numbers, and they are written with the help of words. We add 2 or 3 or 5, 6, 7, whatever number of words, then they make a sentence. Like Rahul is walking. So how many words we have used? We have used 3 words. So with the help of 3 words, we have made a sentence. So this is how we work on sentences. So again, alphabets are 26, vowels are 5, that is A, E, I, O, U, consonant are 21. These are 21 just because we are removing these 5 from 26, so we are left with 21. Words are infinite and sentences are also infinite, that means they are many in numbers. But we write sentences with the help of words, with the group of words. Now, starting with the sentence. The sentence, a group of words that make complete sense is called a sentence. So when we, group of words means when we are using 2, 3, 5, 10 words all together and they are making a complete sense, that is known as sentence. I already told you that we make sentence with the help of words. When we write 2, 3 words or more than 2, 3 words, that will make a sentence. So this is how we make a sentence. So for example, Peter reached home. So here we have used 3 words and we have made a sentence. With the help of 3 words, we have made a sentence. Now, If I'm writing Peter reached, is it making a sense? No, it is wrong. So this is not a sentence. It is not telling where he has reached. If I have written Peter reached school, that means it is making a complete sense. Now it is not making a complete sense just because it is not telling where Peter has reached. Now Peter jumped. This is not giving any sense to the sentence just because it is not complete sentence. If I have written Peter jumped out of the window, that means it is known that Peter has jumped out of the window. That means that is a complete sentence, but now it is not a complete sentence. The cat is under. Is it making a complete sense? No, it is wrong. Just because it is only written the cat is under. Under what? It is not mentioned. If I have written the cat is under the table, that means it is correct. This is right. But before I had written the cat is under, that was not the complete sentence and it was wrong. Now it is right. Just because it is telling that the cat is under the table, so it is giving a complete sense now. So this is how we make a sentence. You should learn to make small sentences by using small words. You can write a sentence on yourself also, like my name is, my hobby is. These are the small sentence which you can start from. Now we need to know that sentence has two parts. Before writing the sentence, we should know that it has two parts, that is, first is naming part and second is telling part. Naming part is the person who's doing the thing, who's doing the action. The boy, the cat, the dog, or Rahul, or whatever, the person or animal or thing, whatever, whose name has come, whether it is cat, dog, animal, or whatever. That means that is the naming part, and telling part is what is the action that person is performing. That is telling part. So for example, the girl is laughing. So the girl is what? Naming. This is naming part. Is laughing is what? The telling part. So girl is naming, that means here is the name. It is naming doesn't mean that name has to come. No, it is the person, the object, or if we are talking about animals, the animal name or whatever, it has to be someone. That is the naming part, and whatever the action is performed by that particular person is the telling part. So here, what is the girl is naming and is laughing, what is the action she is doing, that is laughing is telling part. So this is how we know this. So we need to write, this is the first exercise, we need to write what is the naming part and what is the telling part. So the girl is laughing, so naming part is the girl. This is the naming part. And if I'm talking about telling part is laughing. So this is the telling part. So this is how we know that this is the naming part and this is the telling part. Coming to the next one, Ria is dancing. So Ria is naming part and is dancing is telling part. So this is how we know this is naming part and this is telling part. Now coming to the next one, a bird saw the cat. So naming part is a bird is naming part, saw the cat is telling part. So coming to the next, the sun rises in the east. So naming part is the sun rises in the east is telling part. So this is how we got to know that in a sentence we have two parts, naming part and telling part. So again I'm repeating for you, the girl is laughing, the naming part is the girl, and the telling part is laughing. So this is how we know naming part is the girl and telling part is laughing. So this is the action which the girl is performing, that means she is laughing, she is doing some action, that is telling part. And naming part is the person or animal, whosoever is doing that action is the naming part. Ria is dancing. So Ria is the person who is performing the action. So naming part is Ria and is dancing is telling part. So this is how we got to know that Riya is naming part and is dancing is telling part. A bird saw the cat. So here the naming part is a bird. Just because this bird is performing something, no? The bird is looking at the cat. He saw the cat. The bird saw the cat. So here the naming part is a bird. Just because the bird is doing some action. And telling part is saw the cat. Telling part is saw the cat. So here we got to know that a bird which is performing some action, that means a bird saw the cat. In this sentence, naming part is a bird and telling part is saw the cat. Coming to the next, the sun rises in the east. So what is, who's performing the action is that sun. So naming part is the sun. And what is the action which is performed by sun? That is telling part. And what is that? Rises in the east. So this is how we know what is the naming part and the telling part. Now coming to the next exercise, which is little hard for you, but you need to understand it with, I'll start from the last one because these I have written little easier one. So here I have written some sentences. These are sentences, but they are written jumbled up. You need to rearrange these sentences. So, boys naughty are. Is it making a sense? No. It will make a sense when we will write it in a complete sense. So, to write in a complete sense, we should know that how we can arrange this. If I'll write naughty are boys, is it correct sentence? No. If I'll write are boys naughty? No. But what, how will I make the sentence out of it is that boys are naughty. So this is how I'm making it. Boys are naughty. Now this is the perfect sentence and which is giving a sense to it. It is giving a complete sense to it. So this is how I made out of this. We need to think. We have been given some words. Three words are given. We need to arrange these words in a sense that it is making a sentence and that sentence is giving a complete sense. It is not that it is any way we are writing the words here and there. No, it has to give a complete sense. So this sentence now is giving a complete sense. Boys are naughty. So here what we are getting to know that boys are naughty. Now, elders obey your. Is it giving a sense? No, it is wrong sentence. So how we can write it so that we can get a perfect sentence out of it? So if I write obey your elders, obey your elders. Now is it right or wrong? It is right, because it is giving a complete sense that we should obey our elders or we should obey your elders. So this is how we are writing the sentence. Now coming to the next one, your work on time finish. So this is little big sentence, but you need to rearrange the sentence, use your mind little bit extra so that you can write the complete sentence yourself. So how we can write this thing? We can start it from finish. Finish your work on time. So this is how we are writing. Finish your work on time. So this is how we write. Finish your work on time. So this sentence is giving a complete sense and it is a perfect sentence without any mistake. But this was not perfect. This was haphazardly written. Words are given, but this is haphazardly written and it is not giving a sense to the sentence. So this is how we write finish your work on time. Now, at yesterday were not school day. So how we can write it? We can start with they were not at school yesterday. So this is how we can write they were not at school yesterday. So this is how we write, or how we can write this we can write in two ways. We can write yesterday they were not at school. This sentence can be written in two ways. Like yesterday can go at last also, and yesterday can come in the starting also. So how we are writing it, they were not at school yesterday. So here we are telling that they were not at there at school yesterday. Now here also we are telling the same sentence, yesterday they were not at school. So this is how we can write this sentence in two ways. So these both are correct. It just we have written yesterday in this one at last, and here we have started with yesterday only. So coming up to the second one, music like the I evening listening into. So we need to think that which word how we can start with, like I like to listen. No, we cannot write it like this. We can write it like this. I like listening to music in the evening. So now it is giving a complete sense. I like listening to music in the evenings. So this is making a complete sentence, and it is giving a sense to the sentence also. So now coming to the first one, I have started it from last one just because these were little easy and we are going towards the harder ones. That's why I have started from the last one. Now coming to the first one, brother, has a your job got? So this is, here it is given a question mark. That means this has to be start as a question, in which a question is asked. So how we can start? Has your brother got a job and a question mark? So in this question, by reading this sentence only, we came to know that we are asking a question from someone. Has your brother got a job? So this is the question, and the second person has to answer that, has your brother got the job? So the answer would be yes, he has got the job, or he has not got the job. So these types of questions, these type of sentences has question mark in the last. These question mark help us to know that we have to start the sentence with a question only. Otherwise, how we will put the question mark if we are not starting the sentence with the question only? So this is how we do these sentences. I'm not giving you to write sentence yourself, to make the sentence yourself. That is little next stage, but you should know how to make a sentence out of these wrong haphazard words. So this is how we do it. So again, I'm repeating from the last one only, just because these are little easy. Boys naughty are. So I have written boys are naughty. Elders obey your obey your elders. Your work on time finish. Finish your work on time. At yesterday were not school day. So one will be they were not at school yesterday, and one will be yesterday they were not at school. These both are correct. Now after that, music like the I evening listening into. I like listening to music in the evenings. So this is how it has come. Then brother, has a your job got? Has your brother got a job? So this has come out to be a question sentence. Okay, now this is how we do the exercises. That's all for these sentence exercises. Making a sentence out of a word, that will be a next stage, that will be in your next class. But till this standard, you should know how to rearrange these jumble words, we can say, but that are giving us a sentence at last. So this is how we do. Again, I'm repeating, there are 26 alphabets, 5 vowels. After removing 5 vowels out of 26, we are left with 21. They are consonant. words are always infinite just because there are thousands and thousands of words all around. Then these words can be written with the help of vowels also and consonant also. Sentences are so many, but sentence we write with the help of words. With a group of words we write the sentence. So what we got to know, a group of words that make complete sense is called a sentence. When we are using group of words and that is giving a complete sense, it is not like that we are using any words and we are saying this is a sentence. No, if we are using group of words, that should give a complete sense, a sensible meaning should come out of it, so that is known as a sentence. So if I am writing Peter reached home, it is giving a complete information that Peter, a person whose name is Peter, has reached home. This is giving a complete sense. Now Peter reached, is it giving a complete sense? No. Where he has reached, we don't know, so this is wrong. Peter jumped, is it giving a complete information? No, so this is wrong. The cat is under the table, this is giving the complete information, so this is correct. And we got to know that a sentence has two parts, a naming part and a telling part. Naming part is the person who's performing the activity, who's doing the action, and telling part is the action which is performed by that particular person. So that is telling part. I'm giving you one example again, this we have already done. The girl is laughing, so the girl is, the person is laughing is the action which is being performed by this girl. So naming part is the girl, and is laughing part is telling part. So this is how we are done with this exercise, that is the sentence. You can rewrite these sentences, the question sentences, and marking so that you can clearly see these are the questions, and where I have put the arrows, those are the answers, those are the complete sentences which are giving a complete sense, perfect information is coming out of it. You can rewrite these, which where I have marked this pink, and you can practice yourself by doing it. First of all, do it after looking, and later on you can do it without looking at it. I'll upload the PDF of this chapter, the sentence, on Snap Homework. You can get it from there, and you can practice, you can learn what all is there in the sentence. So we are done with this chapter, the sentence. Thank you for the class.